Greetings, I'm Kay Sparling, Artistic Director and owner of Sparling Theatrical Productions Incorporated. The performers would like to dedicate this gala concert to the Fairhaven residents and staff. This concert was originally scheduled in June of last year, but due to COVID-19 was canceled. In October, the company was able to purchase audio and video equipment through the generous donations of some of our patrons. From there, we commenced transforming my teaching studio in my home to a recording studio. Learning to operate this equipment proved to be challenging, but we persevered until we were able to begin recording. I am very gratified to have worked with these young singers and observed how they've developed their vocal technique and artistry through months of disappointing cancellations of their music and theater performances. Although the performing arts have been in shutdown mode, these young people never gave up. I'm sure this experience will serve them well in the future. So without further ado, we present our show, Toy Toy, and I will see you at the end of the gala. In this scene, Grace, a lyric coloratura soprano, and I are playing the role of Loretta in Gianni Schicchi. Gianni is our father, and he has just betrothed Loretta to marry an old baron so Gianni can be rich. Loretta is very headstrong and flat out refuses. In this aria, she begs him to let her marry a young count she has met. And if he doesn't call off the wedding, she will run to the Ponte Vecchio bridge and drown herself in the Arno River. Yes, Loretta is a bit of a drama queen. Grace, being in the spring of her career, is making her debut in this role, and I, in the winter of my career, am honored to sing my last performance of this with my lovely student. I know she will sing this many times in the exciting career ahead of her. Lucy Natale, our youngest singer in the company, has sang many lead roles throughout southeastern Wisconsin during her young career. Although she is only in eighth grade, you wouldn't know it when you hear her well-developed voice. She will be singing the role of Millie in a scene from Thoroughly Modern Millie. This musical is set in the roaring 20s in New York City. Millie's a flapper who has moved to the big city to marry a rich man. She works in a secretary pool and is very fond of Jimmy, a penniless salesman. But she has her sights on Trevor, a well-heeled company man. Her plan goes awry, and in the end, she discovers that Jimmy isn't penniless. He was testing Millie.
A simple choice, nothing more. This or that, either or. Very well, social world businessman. Clever girl, or pin my future on a green glass love. What kind of life am I dreaming of? I say, gimme that thing called love. Gimme that thing called love. I need it. Highs and lows, tears and laughter. Gimme happy ever after. Gimme that thing called love. Gimme that thing called love. Gimme that thing called love. I'll brave it, thick and thin, rich or poor time. Gimme years and I'll want more time. Gimme that thing called love. Gimme that thing called love. I'm free now. Gimme that thing called love. I see now fly, dove, sing, sparrow. It's famous arrow. Gimme that thing called love. I don't care if he's a nobody. In my heart, he'll be a somebody. Somebody to love me. I need it.
Next, I will be singing a sacred aria, Agnus Dei, composed by Bizet. Although Bizet's best-known opera is Carmen, this Agnus Dei claims to be his most famous sacred aria. My accompaniment in this piece is played on a 5-manual Aeolian Skinner pipe organ built in 1926 in the great St. Bartholomew's Cathedral in New York City. Due to COVID-19, the organist had to record it, send it to me, and then I sang with the recording. A new procedure in recording, that's for sure. Some of the venues that I have sung this piece include the Vatican, St. Patrick's Cathedral in New York City, and the Stephansdom in Vienna. The Latin translation is, Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Thank you.
Megan Miller, musical theater character singer, will perform this next song. She is playing the role of Adelaide in Guys and Dolls. This musical is set in New York City in the 1930s. Adelaide is a dance hall girl that's been engaged to Nathan, a high-rolling gambler, for 14 years. It's been really getting to her lately, and in this scene, she tells the whole sordid story and how waiting around for that little band of gold can give a female a bad, bad cold.
The average unmarried female, basically insecure, due to some long frustration, maybe act with psychosomatic symptoms, difficult to endure, affecting the upper respiratory tract. In other words, just from waiting around for that plain little band of gold, a poison can develop a cold. You can spray her wherever you think in the streptococci like. You can give her a shot for whatever she's got, but it just won't like. If she's tired of getting the fish eye from the hotel clique, a poison can develop a cold. It says here, the female remaining single, just in a legal sense, shows a neurotic tendency. See note. Note. Chronic organic syndromes, toxic hypertense, involving the eye, the ear, and the nose and throat. In other words, just for worrying whether the wedding is on or off, a poison can develop a cough. You can feed her all day with the vitamin A and the bromo fizz, but the medicine never gets anywhere near where the trouble is. If she's getting a kind of a name for herself and the name ain't his, a poison can develop a cough. And furthermore, installing the bat and twip, a poison can develop. Look her up. When they get on the train for Niagara and they can hear church bells chime, the compartment is air conditioned and the mood sublime. Then they get off at Saratoga for the 14th time.
Grace McMahon will now sing The Girl in 14G. This scene was composed for Broadway singer sensation Kristen Chenoweth. It is quite demanding vocally due to the soprano having to sing three styles for three different characters at the same time, opera, jazz, and Broadway. The poor, meek, stay-at-home girl who just moved into 14G doesn't know what her neighbors have in store for her. Let's find out.
Just moved in to 14G, so cozy, calm, and peaceful. Heaven for a mouse like me, with quiet by the leaseful. Pets are banned, parties too, and no solicitations. Window seat with garden view, a perfect nook to read a book. I'm lost in my Jane Austen when I hear isn't so. Not the flat below. From an opera wannabe in 13G, a matinee of some cantata, Wagner's Ring and Traviata. In 14G, I'll put up with Puccini. Brew myself a cup of tea. Crochet until she's feeny. 8:30, not a peep, except the clock tick-tocking. Now I lay me down to sleep. A comfy bed. To rest my head, a stretch, a yawn, I'm almost gone then. Do we swah, do ta doop, do spilly dee, boy be blip. Na 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 na, woo wee! Now the girl upstairs wakes me unawares. Blowing down from 15G, her reveille. She's scatting like her name is Ella. Guess who answers a cappella? Zoo-doo-doo, boy, boy. Zoo-doo-doo, boy, boy. I'm not one to raise my voice, make a fuss, or speak my mind, but might I query, would you mind if, could you kindly, how do I say this, stop, that felt good, boy, stop. Had my fill of peace and quiet. Shout out loud, I've changed my diet. All because of 14G.
Elijah Erdman, tenor, will perform Love Changes Everything from the same composer that brought us the Broadway smash Phantom of the Opera, Andrew Lloyd Webber. This song is from his show Aspects of Love. This musical focuses on the many forms that love takes in the story. Love between couples, both as romantic infatuation and as married people, and adult children's love for their parents and families. Elijah will sing the role of Alex Dillingham, who in this song reflects on his love life over the past 17 years.
Changes everything, how you live and summer fly, or a night seem like a lifetime. Yes, love, love changes everything. Now I tremble at your name. Nothing in the world will ever be the same.
Megan will play the feminist-minded newspaper reporter Catherine Plummer in New York City during the Newsboys strike of 1899. This strike is based on a true story. Although she's only allowed to write in the Women's Society pages, she meets Jack, a leader of the downtrodden orphaned Newsboys, who discovers that the newspaper has raised the cost of newspapers to 60 cents per hundred, and then declares the Newsies to be a union and organizes protest. Catherine decides to cover the strike, seeing it as an opportunity to be taken more seriously as a journalist. In this scene, she lays out her plan to write her story. The next day, her story makes the front page. This really ticks off the New York Sun, and they hire scabs to take the boys' jobs. Finally, the Newsies find an old printing press and start their own newspaper, with Jack drawing cartoons making fun of the established press. Roosevelt sees the cartoons and is motivated to aid the Newsboys' cause. Catherine Plummer, a character in musical theater portraying a true American suffragist.
Write what you know, so they say. All I know is I don't know what to write or the right way to write it. This is Big Lady, don't screw it up. This is not some little vaudeville I'm reviewing. Poor little kids versus rich, greedy sourpusses, huh? It's a cinch. It could practically write itself. And let's pray it does. Because as I may have mentioned, I have no clue what I'm doing. Am I insane? This is what I've been waiting for. Well, that plus the screaming of 10 angry editors. A girl? It's a girl. How the hell is that even legal? Look, just go and get her. Not only that, there's a story behind the story. Thousands of children exploited, invisible. Speak up, take a stand. There's someone to write about it. That's how things get better. Give life's little guy some ink. And when it dries, just watch what happens. Those kids will live and breathe right on the page. And once they're center stage, you watch what happens. And who's there with her camera and her pen? As boys turn into men, they'll storm the gates and then just watch what happens when they do. Picture a handsome, heroically charismatic, plain-spoken, know-nothing, skirt-chasing, cocky little son of a, lie down with dogs and you wake up with a raise and a promotion. So he's a flirt, a complete egomaniac. The fact is he's also the face of the strike. What a face, face the fact. That's a face that could save us all from sinking in the ocean. Like someone said, power tends to corrupt, and absolute power wait, corrupts. Absolutely, that is genius. But give me some time, I'll be twice as good as that 6 months from never. Just look around at the world we're inheriting and think of the one we'll create. Their mistake is they got old. That is not a mistake we'll be making. No, sir, we'll stay young forever. Give those kids and me the brand new century and watch what happens. It's David and Goliath, do or die. The fight is on and I can't watch what happens. But all I know is nothing happens if you just give in. It can't be any worse than how it's been. And it just so happens that
next, I will sing You'll Never Walk Alone from Rodgers and Hammerstein's Carousel. This musical is set in a small millworker town in Maine in 1873. It is centered around two young millworkers, Julie and Nettie, and the events that happen to them when they visit the town's carousel after work. Julie is seen out late by the owner of the mill and is fired. She's met the carousel barker, Billy, and decides to get married to him. The marriage is difficult due to Billy's drinking and carrying on. As the years pass, Julie suffers greatly to that fateful night at the carousel. In this scene, Nettie arrives and gives Julie the support to keep going despite her despair. I dedicate this song to my mother, Darlene. She remained my dearest and most loyal fan since my professional debut at 7 years old, when I played the youngest of the Von Trapp children in Sound of Music. Throughout the decades, this song was dear to her heart, and in rough times, she always asked me to sing it to her. She passed in 2019, but I know she's still listening.
At the end
Lucy will sing Tomorrow from Annie. In this scene, Annie has just ran away from a Depression-era orphanage in New York City. She's walking through a section of Central Park when a stray dog comes up to her. They become friends instantly, but an officer comes up and starts asking a lot of probing questions. Annie has to think on her feet so she doesn't get sent back to the mean Miss Hannigan at the orphanage. Despite the rough times that Annie's had, she remains an optimist as she sings how things are going to be better tomorrow.
Sandy color.
Okay, let's see him answer to his name.
Okay. Here, boy. Here, Sandy. Sandy, here, boy. Sandy! Good Sandy. Good old Sandy.
Well, maybe he is your dog, but the next time you take him out, I want to see him on a leash and with a license, or else he goes to the pound and they put him to sleep. You understand?
Yes, ma'am, I understand. A leash and with a license.
Now get along with you before you catch your death of cold in this weather.
Oh, I don't mind the weather. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick up my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out.
Eli will now sing I'm Alive from the musical Next to Normal. This modern musical deals with the somber subject of Diana, a mother with worsening bipolar disorder, and the effects that managing her illness has on her family. This musical won the 2010 Pulitzer Prize for Drama and is recognized by many mental health organizations. In this scene, Eli plays the role of Gabe, Diana's son that was killed 16 years ago, but she still won't accept that he's gone. During a hypnosis session, the ghost of Gabe comes to her and sings, I'm Alive.
Mm-hmm.
destruction, decay, and desire. I'll hurt you. I'll heal you. I'm your wish, your dream come true, and I am your darkest nightmare too. I've shown you.
Next, Grace will sing the role of Gilda, the daughter of the court jester Rigoletto, in Verdi's Rigoletto. In this scene, Gilda, who is cooped up and overly protected by her father, has secretly met who she thinks is a student and fallen deeply in love. What she doesn't know is that he is actually a duke, tricking her to get back at her father. She goes to the garden after he leaves and declares her love in the famous coloratura aria, Caro Nome. This aria has many high C's, D's, and E's. I think you'll be pleased at Grace's execution of these passages. I'd like to mention that Grace is 18 years old.
Ra.
Sahara. Col pensier il mio desir a te sempre volerò.
Now I will sing the sacred song Bless This House, composed in 1927 by Australian composer May Bray and lyrics by English woman Helen Taylor. Women composers weren't common in those days. This song has been recorded by many artists and has been sung at inaugurations and Thanksgiving services. My first public appearance was at my church's Thanksgiving Eve service when I was 7 years old. I still remember that night. My entire extended family filled two pews, and I think each of them was more nervous than me. I remember my grandma crying, and until the day she died, this song remained her favorite song for me to sing. I'd like to dedicate this song to my grandma, Sylvia Russell Sisco, and to all the Fairhaven family who live here in this house. May God bless you and keep you safe.
Bless the people here with thee.
Grace, Megan, and I will sing a famous hit during World War II sung by the Andrews Sisters, the Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy of Company B. We singers have a new appreciation for the Andrews Sisters. Boy, was their harmony tight and not easy to learn. We hope this brings you folks memories of your heyday. We had a lot of fun putting it together. Our scenario for this scene. Grace is in the service and Megan works at a nearby artillery plant. I decide to take my daughters tonight to a big band dance and somebody recognizes me and asks me to sing. I invite Grace and Megan to join me. As we walk to the stage, cadets throw us their caps and off we go. We'd like to dedicate this piece to the Fairhaven veterans of World War II, the Korean War, and the Vietnam War. Thank you for your service. I'd also like to dedicate it to my dad, Bill Sparling, Army, 1st Armored Division, World War II, Patton's Army, and who first introduced me to this wonderful big band music. The final piece of the concert is a song that came into my repertoire during 9/11. I was asked to sing the funerals and memorial services for the fallen civil service workers. Every family chose this piece to be a song for their loved one. I think that is a testament to their patriotic loyalty to their country. Since moving to Wisconsin, I have chosen to close every performance with this song. I think more than ever, it is very pertinent during these turbulent times.
God bless America. Land that I love. home, sweet home. God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with the light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans white with foam. God bless America, my home, sweet home. God bless America, my home.
I hope you've enjoyed our show. It was a real challenge scheduling video tapings due to so many interruptions involving COVID-19. All of the arts have been severely affected worldwide during this crisis. As a vocal coach in the winter of my career, it deeply concerns me as to how the arts community will pick up the pieces so that the future artists will have career opportunities. I urge each of you to attend live performances, go to movies, and donate as much as possible to nonprofit arts organizations like Sparling Theatrical Productions Incorporated. I have lived as a performer through many decades and have experienced setbacks in the arts. First, it was the recession in the 1970s when I was just getting started. Then the AIDS epidemic in the 80s and 90s when I moved to New York City to start my apprenticeship. I was still living as a performer in New York City during and after 9/11, which caused a mass exodus of artists from the city. Next came the Great Recession in 2008 when I was trying to keep a conservatory of music and theater alive here in southeastern Wisconsin. I have lived through many hard times and somehow remained in the arts industry. But never have I seen the extended shutdown of the arts that this pandemic has caused. I am committed for the rest of my life to solve the logistical and economical challenges that it will take to bring the arts back for generations to come. Please join me in that effort. Presently, more than half the lessons of my students in my studio are paid by scholarships from donations. Thank you for watching this concert. I'm sorry that it couldn't be a live performance. I was looking forward to you meeting these fine singers from this region. Remember their names, because I am sure they are up-and-coming stars. I'd also like to thank my students for performing. They are not only good singers, but they are also good people from good families. And I am blessed to have the honor of being their teacher. Following will be a picture and bio of each of the performers. And until next time, toy toy!
When I'm lying at night, going out of my mind, thinking a million things a second. When I'm out of my depth and troubles over my head, yeah. Whenever my life gets heavy, they'll always be there for me. They'll always be there for me. When I'm lost, I'm lucky I've got good people helping me out. Yeah, I've got good people there when I'm down. Yeah, I've got good people lifting me up when I'm low. I'm lucky, I know. Good people. When I was pretty much spent after paying my rent, and I could barely afford a coffee. When she was kicking me out, and I showed up unannounced with all of my things and boxes. They've always been there for me. They've always been there for me.
We've all got good people in life to be thankful for.